What's up, Christ United kids? It is September and we have a brand new challenge for the entire month. It's called the ABCs of September. And to get started, you need a couple things. So the first thing is you need some plain paper. It can be lined paper, it can be whatever you have, but you need 7 sheets. All right, so make sure you count 7. And then you're gonna take it and you're gonna fold it in half. And if you have a stapler, you're going to staple it along the sides. Okay, so basically you're making like a little book. Then on the cover, I want you to write, like I did, the ABCs of September 2020. All right, the next few weeks, we are gonna go through the alphabet and learn a life skill, an attribute, every single day that starts with the letter that we're on. Then we're gonna dig into God's word and see what God has to say about this. It's gonna help us to get better at school. It's gonna help us to get excited about what's happening. It's gonna help us to learn to love and follow Jesus even more. So, and because it's a challenge, if you bring your book completely filled out to the October 4th Pelican Stadium celebration service that we're having, then you will get a free Chick-fil-A gift card. All right. So not only will you have an awesome book with all of these awesome life skills that we all need to be using, you'll also get free Chick-fil-A. So that's pretty exciting. All right. You guys got your books and are you ready? Obviously, we're going to start with the letter A. So on your first page, which is on the very back of your cover, you're going to write A is for attitude. A is for attitude. And if you are little and cannot write, maybe you can just write the letter A. Try writing the letter A. If not, your mom or your dad or your brother or sister can write A is for attitude for you. All right? So A is for attitude. Let's talk about attitude. Everybody knows someone and has probably met someone who has a bad attitude. Somebody that has a bad attitude is somebody who complains and doesn't want to do anything. Maybe they're disrespectful. Maybe they're not nice and they're super ugly. Having a bad attitude is not living like Jesus. God calls us to have good attitudes. And so A is for attitude. We don't want to have an attitude that is not what God wants it to be. So how do we know what kind of attitude God wants us to have? Well, grab your Bibles. We are in Philippians 4, and we're going to be in verse 8. All right? We did this verse one time over the summer, so you might be familiar with it. You might even already have it underlined in your Bible. But this is how we have a good attitude. It says, "Finally, brothers, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think about such things. Whatever you have learned or received or heard from me or seen in me, put it into practice, and the peace of God will be with you." So God is telling us, in order for us to have a good attitude, we need to think about the things that are true, that are noble, that are right, that are pure, that are lovely, that are admirable. We need to think about the things that are excellent and praiseworthy. And then when we do those things, we need to practice. We need to make sure that everything that we've learned this summer, everything that we've learned from God's word, that we put it into practice. And then we will have a good attitude. All right? So we need to think about the things that are good so that we can have a good attitude. I think also we really need to pray and ask God to help us to have good attitudes. So let's do that right now. Dear Jesus, we thank you so much. God, today we ask that you would fill us with a great attitude. No matter what is happening around us, Lord, help us to think about the things that are praiseworthy, that are noble, that are good, that are right. God, fill our minds and our hearts with you and your thoughts, so that our attitude can be one that brings you honor and glory. And all God's children said, amen. All right, so here's what you can do. You have a couple choices. In my book, I wrote the verse Philippians 4, 8 and 9, so that when I go back and I say, A is for attitude, I know where to find the verse. Then I wrote a little prayer. I said, Lord, give me a good attitude today. So, if you are an older elementary child, I want you, can write just like this. If you are younger, then you can draw a picture of what it looks like to have a good attitude. What do you think your face looks like when you have a good attitude? Probably super smiley. Maybe you're giving somebody a high five. Maybe you're encouraging someone or listening to your mom or your dad or your teacher. Those are all ways that we have good attitudes. So, you can write A, if you're younger, and then you can have them fill in is for attitude, and then you can draw a picture of you having a good attitude. Or you can do like I did and write down where the verse is. You can even write the verse out and then write a little prayer and ask God to help you to have a good attitude. All right? Be sure to check in tomorrow as we keep working on our ABCs of September. I'll see you then. Thanks.